So we have all these fields added to the page layout in theory. So now I can go add a record.
Yep, but don't forget to click save, because that's like the easiest thing to forget, and then it just loses all your work.
Okay, I would never want to do something like that. Okay, cool. Now all of these fields are there, but obviously they're not populated yet, so I just hit edit, and I'll fill out these fields. Okay, so there's going to be a ton of bands coming to this festival.
Right.
I guess this is the tedious part where I just have to enter them all in, or is there any other way we can do this?
So you can save this record, but there's a really easy way to take spreadsheets, or more specifically, CSVs, and put them into Salesforce using what we call the custom import wizard.
Okay.
Let's just go into the setup, and then we can import our CSV to load those records into Salesforce.
Okay. So I want to import something. Should I just search import up here?
Yeah, don't try and memorize any click paths. Let's just search for the import.
There's a few import things. Which one should I use?
Import custom objects is probably the safest bet.
Okay.
I don't trust anything in beta.
Fair enough.
This tells you all the steps that you need in order to be able to import custom objects, but we'll just walk through it ourselves. Don't need to read all that text.
And we have this CSV that you showed me here, this spreadsheet.
Right.
The band spreadsheet.
Yeah, so we have all of our fields along the top, and then each row represents a record.
Mm-hmm.
And if for any reason, let's say you spelled your fields different than the way we have it up in the column names or column headers, we could just manually match them.
Okay.
It'll automatically try and do it for you, but if anything's misspelled or anything like that, you can manually map them yourselves.
Okay, cool. So let's close this and start the import wizard.
Let's do it.
Choose the type of record you're importing. That would be banned.
Do you want to prevent duplicates from being created?
Yeah, I don't want two bands with the same name.
Right. That's right.
Yep.
We want to make sure the band names are unique.
Okay.
Got it.
If existing records are found, what do you want to do? There won't be, so I guess it doesn't really matter. What's this mean? Which user field are you including?
Well, since we're not including any user fields, we can just leave it as default. Or I guess we could put none.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what about this? Which lookup fields, if any, are included in your import file? Well, our spreadsheet didn't have a stage on it, right?
Right.
So I should not click it?
Yes.
Right. Yes, I should not?
You should not click it. Yes. Now we need to choose the CSV file. So look it up on your computer and add in those bands. All right, and you can leave that as default.
Okay.
We haven't written any workflow rules, so we don't need to check that box.
Okay. Field mapping. Is this that step you were talking about where band name. Oh, that looks good.
Yeah, so it's mapped some of them because they're exactly the same as what they are in your CSV.
Mm-hmm.
But for some of them, like has piano,
uh-huh.
it needs piano.
Oh, yeah. Whoops. Okay, so I'll go through and I'll change those. So we actually didn't add special requests as a field in our band object, so can I just say ignore those special requests?
Yeah.
And again, same thing with expect to draw. Just leave a blank.
And it tells you there those values just won't be imported. That's fine. We can just click OK.
Import now.
Awesome. So it's basically just going to put it into a queue. It'll import it when it can, and then you'll get an email when it's done.
Cool. All right. So finish.